Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Get Started with Jenkins series. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get your source code from a Git repository into Jenkins. This is obviously very crucial as you want to perform tests on your code and ultimately deploy it. So what's next for this video? Well, first of all, I'm going to install Git onto my Jenkins server. Then I'm going to install the Git plugin for Jenkins. I'm also going to create a new job and configure the Git integration, and then we're going to test to see if everything works correctly. So let's begin. So the first thing that we have to do is we have to install Git onto our Jenkins server. Here I've opened up an SSH connection to my Jenkins server, and the only thing that I need to do to install Git is simply run sudo apt-get install git. And this will take care of the installation of Git. So now that Git is installed, we can install the Git plugin for Jenkins. And this plugin basically teaches Jenkins how it can communicate with the Git program. So I'm going to open up my browser and I'm going to go to my Jenkins installation, which is on my local network. And I'm going to click on Manage Jenkins. Now in this page, we're going to go for Manage Plugins to add the new plugin. And then I'm going to open the tab Available. And in here, I get a list of all the available plugins for Jenkins. Now, there is a filter option here. So in the filter option, I'm going to type Git plugin. And in the search results here, the last one is Git plugin. And it says this plugin allows the use of Git as a source control management. Okay, so that's what we want. So I'm going to click on this. And I'm going to say download now and install after restart. After this, it's required to restart Jenkins, so I'm going to tick this box here and wait until Jenkins is restarted. So after the restart of Jenkins, I went back to the homepage, and now it's time to create our very first job. So I'm going to click on Create New Jobs, and I'm going to give my job a name. I'm going to call it My First Jenkins Job, and I'm going to create a freestyle project so that we can have full control over it, and I'm going to click OK. And now in the next screen, we can instruct Jenkins on what it should do when we trigger a build. Now what we want to do is we want to tell Jenkins that if a build is started, you should download the source code of our project. So to do that, you have to go down to the source code management section and click on Git. And here we can tell Jenkins on where our Git repository is stored. So I'm going to give it the URL of one of my public repositories on GitHub. This is JS TixClock. It's a TixClock written in JavaScript. It's really cool. You should check it out. Now, if this repository was private, I could instruct Jenkins to use some credentials to authenticate with this repository. But since this repository is public, that's not needed. In the next section, I can tell Jenkins which branch it should build. Now, I'm going to leave this to default because all my code is in the master branch. And pretty much the rest of the settings for Git, I'm going to leave to default as well, and I'm just going to hit the Save button. So now that that's done, we can manually trigger a build. In the left column, you can click on Build Now to actually start the build. And now Jenkins will run through all its tasks, but since we only added the Git task, it will just download our source code and do further nothing. So naturally, the build finishes really quickly. So if I go here on the first build, I can see that everything went well. I can go to console output to see some more details, and here I can see that it's actually cloning the remote Git repository and that it has finished with a success. So that's it for this video. We manually started a build in Jenkins. Want to learn more about Jenkins? Well, in the next video, I'll show you how you can integrate Jenkins with Bitbucket so that you don't have to manually start the build after each commit. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if you like my videos, make sure to subscribe to my channel or follow me on Twitter.